This week, some incredible research came out in reference to an extract from edible seaweed. Now, heparin is what we're looking at. But what the researchers did is they formulated a form of heparin called trisulfated heparin, which stripped it of its anticoagulant ability. However, though, what that meant is it referred to, or I should say, resulted in lower cellular toxicity. Yet, this trisulfated form of heparin, derived from edible seaweeds, otherwise made known as the fucoidins, basically was on par with current antivirals. And but what brought the attention, again, worthy of bookmark, was that low cellular toxicity. Also, the caveat here, we're looking at a cellular level or a cellular experiment. We're not looking at basically in reference to a higher organism such as a mouse or a human. So we got a long way to go, but let us begin with looking into the research itself. DOI citation, the link will be there for you, of course, as always. But to proceed, in cell studies, seaweed extract outperforms remdesivir in blocking, in blocking COVID-19 virus. In a test of antiviral effectiveness against the virus that caused COVID-19, an extract from edible seaweed substantially outperformed, I am quoting, remdesivir, the current standard antiviral used to combat the disease. Heparin, a common blood thinner, and heparin variant, we talked about the trisulfated heparin, stripped of its anticoagulant properties, performed on par with remdesivir, in inhibiting SARS-CoV-2 infection in mammalian cells. Again, long way to go before this research becomes truly fruitful. To proceed, the spike protein on the surface of SARS-CoV-2 latches onto the ACE2 receptor, a molecule on the surface of human cells. Once secured, the virus inserts its own genetic material into that cell, hijacking the cellular machinery to produce replica viruses. But the virus could just as easily be persuaded to lock onto a decoy molecule, i.e. heparin, that offers a similar fit. The neutralized virus would be trapped and eventually degrade naturally. Previous research has shown that this decoy technique works in trapping other viruses, including dengue, Zika, and influenza A, which is important because I wanted to bookmark this particular research here by doing the video because this can help for future pandemic mitigation. But to proceed and quote, we're learning how to block viral infection, and that is knowledge we're going to need if we want to rapidly confront pandemics. What are the researcher? The reality is that we don't have great antivirals. To protect ourselves against future pandemics, we're going to need an arsenal of approaches that we can quickly adapt to emerging viruses. Hence, the edible seaweeds. Also, to highlight this one particular section, a separate test found no cellular toxicity in any of the compounds, even at the highest concentrations tested. Again, we're looking at the fucoidins that were tested in this particular study, or the trisulfated heparin itself. Now, we're going to take a little bit of a side road here. We're going to go to the full study. And as always, the links will be there if you look into on your own and hopefully research and gather additional information that I do not have time to cover in this one particular video. But to proceed, among the tested polysaccharides, RPI-27 and RPI-28 complex sulfated polysaccharides, fucoidins extracted from the seaweed Saccharina japonica, chemoenzymatically synthesized trisulfated, remember we talked about that, heparin, and unfractionated USP heparin itself were able to complete with heparin for S protein binding. So, a lot of that has meaning to many of you as far as researchers are concerned. However, though, just the same, the links will be there, the DOI citation is there. Again, to reinforce what I said prior, this was not done in animals or humans. This is preliminary. This is pilot. However, though, being an edible form of seaweed that's available, that individuals eventually can basically utilize to manufacture or synthesize inexpensive drugs, in this case, trisulfated heparin, with no cellular toxicity, if this study holds true, can be an incredible boon to mankind, humankind, I should say, as a whole for future generations. Again, Ralph Tarchiano signing off. Thank you. Thank you very much for listening once again. I always appreciate it and look forward to see you all once again in 7 days. Gratitude. Thank you. Catch you then. Bye.